Degrassi is my number one guilty pleasure show, and I'm not embarrassed to say so. Degrassi is a Canadian teen drama series created by Kid Hood and Linda Shuler. The first iteration of Degrassi was known as Kids of Degrassi, a more children-centered show that would later turn into something more familiar, Degrassi Junior High. Degrassi Junior High introduced many concepts not usually seen in TV shows like alcoholism and heavy topics like abortion.
Abortion's wrong. It's like murder.
It is not.
From its conception, the number one motif in Degrassi is in its tagline, "It goes there." Because this show definitely goes there.
His interest in Lucy is more than academic.
I think it's creepy when teachers are too friendly.
And he's getting too close for comfort.
Lucy, can I talk with you, please?
At the end of Degrassi Junior High would come Degrassi High, where underage drinking, premarital sex, and teen pregnancy was all the rage. Degrassi High pushed boundaries Canadian television had never seen before, and the fact that this show only gets crazier just blows my mind.
You were fucking Tessa Campanelli?
No.
Degrassi High lasted from 1989 to 1991, and Degrassi would be gone, but not for long, because in 2001, the next Degrassi series would arrive, and it would be the most iconic run of the series yet. And oh, of course, it goes there. I'm talking about none other than Degrassi, the next generation. Degrassi the Next Generation is a show that defines the early 2000s. From the iconic moment to the funny jokes and the over-the-top story beats, Degrassi The Next Generation was truly for the next generation, as many of the topics talked about in the show are things we still deal with to this day.
Because obviously I'm a moron and don't get it.
Because, man.
Because what?
Because I'm gay.
When I think about Degrassi, I think about all of its dumb antics, Drake in a wheelchair, dumb spinner, Manny trying to be famous. I mean, there's just so many. The first episode of Next Generation literally starts out one of our main characters of the show, Emma, daughter of Spike, who was also into Degrassi Junior High, ends up getting stalked by some creeper online, and eventually goes and meets up with the dude, and this is only the first episode. While season 1 definitely had its fair share of moments, the show doesn't really shine until the later seasons and more time has progressed. So I'm gonna list off some main characters from season 1 through 7 and bring up some of my favorite moments and how I felt about each individual character, starting with, of course, Emma in the earlier seasons is sort of a plant activist and tree hugger. She can sometimes come off sort of privileged, entitled, and just downright pushy, and this attitude gets her in trouble a lot throughout the series. For example, the creepy guy from earlier on the internet, her little fiasco in the woods, this.
Opinion. Exactly. So either shut up or take off the dress.
I am not going to shut up.
And FYI, Emma and Sean are like goals, and I wish the relationship totally lasted. Now for Emma's best friend, Manny. Manny wants to be a famous actor, but sometimes her ambition can get her into trouble. Like when she flashed Peter at a party. Manny discovers her love for attention early when she does this. Boy, you better dig deeper, 'cause I tell you I'm all game down. Uh-huh. Truth is gonna come hit you hard. Think about it. Oh. Manny eventually dates Craig, and Craig has his own problems, but Craig doesn't really like Manny.
She reminds me of my 5-year-old half-sister.
But when she starts being more, oh, how the mighty Craig has fallen.
Why must they be so hot?
Toby exists. He has some funny moments here and there, but he's basically fits the role of the nerdy punching bag kid that people just like to pick on. And damn, now that I think about it, I don't think he's had like one girlfriend throughout the whole show. Like, damn, Toby. I think he starts a podcast and becomes friends with like the school shooter kid. Toby's the punching bag, JT is definitely the heart. JT is the funny kid. I'm pretty sure we've all ran into a JT before in our lives, and he helps push the comedic tone of the show through various gags.
If elected, I, JT York, will do what a real politician would do. Absolutely nothing.
Like him having a wet dream, the whole penis pump fiasco, and this moment just cracks me up every single time.
Remember, we decided to use the king-size condom, the one that slipped off? I'm pregnant.
JT!
Like, whoever wrote this whole large extra condom thing just deserves an Emmy or something, because that is just such a JT thing to do. But JT does get Liberty pregnant, and reality starts to kick in soon for JT, as he soon has to start a job to make money for the upcoming baby. He starts looking for a place for him and Liberty to stay in, and it all starts to become so much, he says fucking and becomes the plug. But eventually, him and Liberty decide adoption is the best way to go, and unfortunately, not soon after this, JT reaches the end of his fate. We love you, JT.
Hey, Liberty girlfriend.
Moving on, let's talk about Sean, the guy who doesn't talk too much and knows things you don't. Sean hangs out with the bad kid crowd, and he dresses like Eminem because, you know, he's a bad kid. Eventually, him and Emma start a little thing, but exam pressure is getting too much, so he decides to beat up Drake, and he accidentally pushes Emma, but they're going strong for a little while, but eventually, they break up. He gets with Ellie after the Breakfast Club episode, but that doesn't go as planned. Eventually, he ends up in the military, and he and Emma date for a little while, but he's gonna be headed off to the military soon, so for one last go around, they decide to remake the photo they took from their first date. Very poetic, if you ask me. Liberty is one out of all 10 of the black people that live in Canada, according to this show. She obviously is supposed to be portrayed as the nerdy girl who wants to be cool and accepted for the most part. It works, but sometimes it can be too much. She tries to get with Chris, the only other black guy in Canada. Emma starts hating, and she's scared that her cool factor might drop.
What are people gonna think of me if Chris goes out with Liberty next?
That's the meanest thing I've ever heard you say.
Not cool, Emma. JT and Liberty eventually do end up together, but JT's dumbass got the magnums instead of the Trojans, so she ends up pregnant. And they give the baby for adoption. Time passes, she ends up getting some alone time with Damien. Damn, there's three of you niggas now? Toby does what Toby does best and starts hating.
I won't tell anyone that Liberty and Damien fooled around and now he's bragging about it.
Snap. Toby, you're kidding, right?
Wait, Emma, didn't you just say this, though?
What are people gonna think of me if Chris goes out with Liberty next?
Oh, how the mighty have fallen. She ends up going to college, but Degrassi can't make an interesting college storyline, so my headcanon is she's a brain surgeon in England married to a famous football player or something. So Miss Paige Michaelchuk is the mean girl of the school. She's totes popular and like has so many friends, and she's just a total bitch. Early on, her and Spinner have a little thing, but Paige's most defining moment in the show is probably the most serious moment in the show. So Paige being a cheerleader gets the attention of another school's player, Dean. When Paige and Dean are both at a party, things escalate, but Paige quickly denies Dean, but he insists anyway, and one of the most traumatic scenes play, and it's honestly still hard to watch to this day. This moment defined Paige's next couple arcs for the ongoing season. At Degrassi, there's a new song contest, only to find out the only song they're supposed to sing represents what happened to Paige. A few more Paige boss moments and a weird driver instructor scandal later, Paige eventually ends up taking Dean to court for what he did, but Dean gets away with it, and Paige crashes Spinner's car. Ashley is, you know, the misunderstood person at the school. Ashley is sort of mean to her friends, but she acts like everyone is just being mean to her. From the beginning, Ashley and Jimmy are a thing. Jimmy's parents are never home, so him and Ashley hang out a lot. Ashley wants to be free, so free in fact, she decides to take the most freeing substance of them all.
This is incredible.
Dude, this is ecstasy.
Ashley ends up making out with Sean, which upsets Jimmy. And we hear the most disrespectful words ever spoken by Aubrey Graham.
Hey, Jimmy.
Don't talk to me, you slut.
Ashley goes goth, and now Craig and Ashley are a thing, but Craig just can't keep the ladies off him. She eventually breaks up with him via email and starts making music with Drake, but she starts realizing the future might be bright for this kid, and starts hating and deletes his verse off the song they were working on. And that's about it. Oh yeah, also she finds out her dad's gay, and this was her reaction.
Your dad is gay.
So Terry has a crush on Spinner, but dashing Paige Michaelchuk has a crush on Spinner too. So how do we solve this problem, you ask? By getting your friends super drunk before the school dance and capitalize on the moment, duh. The show used Terry to display issues bigger women face, like this asshole making fun of her for modeling.
I think you should join our sumo team.
Hey, most girls on the planet look like this, so get used to it.
No kidding.
I
made $500 today as a plus size model. Yeah, plus size. What do you make, ice cream boy?
Eventually, Terry ends up with Rick. He's an abusive piece of shit. He ends up putting Terry in a coma. And the writers write Terry out of the show, and Rick runs away. So, Jimmy is definitely the most recognizable face from the show, I mean.
I go by the name of Drake, thank you for having me.
Jimmy is a series basketball player. Jimmy and Ash have been dating for a while now, and things are going good, until she hooks up with Sean. See, Sean and Jimmy hate each other. But over time, Jimmy learns to forgive Ash. But she goes full emo, he decides it's too much, and they break up. Rick comes back to school, and everyone including Jimmy starts to bully him. Jimmy was the first to try to be nice to Rick, which sucks because, you know, this happens.
What you say? Oh, that you only meant well, cause you did. What you say?
So now Jimmy is paralyzed, and we probably get the best acting Degrassi has ever seen.
Do you wake up every morning thinking you can walk and then remembering that you will never ever walk again?
Thank you, Mr. Graham. Since Jimmy can't hoop anymore, he decides to start drawing, but his dad still thinks he can walk for some reason. Ash and Jimmy eventually do get back together. Jimmy starts rapping.
If you're the beauty and I'm the smart one, there's no problem with that, so I won't start one, you know?
Ash gets jealous and tries to sabotage his career. Let's see how that goes. In the earlier seasons, Spinner is a bully. He gets random boners and he has a little sister named Kendra who disappears after season 3. Spinner and Paige start dating, Rick comes back, and Spinner keeps bullying him, but after Jimmy gets shot, Spinner feels guilty for what happened, like it was his fault, which it kinda was, but that's none of my business. Everybody hates Spinner and he has to pass his test to go back to Degrassi next year, and he does, but everyone still hates him. There's a new girl in town named Darcy, who starts to like Spinner, but Spinner does what Spinner does best and fucks everything up. He lies to Darcy about being a virgin.
I'm so virginal. Mary's jealous.
And his new best friend Jay tries to ruin the relationship by gaslighting Darcy into having sex with Spinner. Spinner gets into a fight with Jay, but Darcy eventually finds out Spinner was lying and she breaks up with him. And to celebrate, he hooks up with Paige. Darcy realizes she kinda overreacted and they get back together, but once again, Darcy and Spinner officially break up. Spinner starts crushing on the new girl, Jane, but finds out he has testicular ball cancer. I know, crazy. Spinner graduates and gets a job at the Dot, but gets rejected and pulled a Spinner and lied to Jane. Holly J exposes the truth to Jane and they break up and get back together. Ah, young love. Spinner gets shot and oh, Jane starts cheating on Spinner. And that does not make him happy. They break up and Spinner and Emma get drunk one night and end up married. Don't ask me, just watch the show. Jane tries to call it off, but Manny is a real one and she's not letting this happen.
No one is going to ruin Emma's wedding!
Overall, Degrassi is a show that is loved by many, and recently has been gaining more and more public attention. I definitely didn't cover every character, storyline, and plot point I wanted to in this video, so if you want a part 2, just make sure you like the video. But in today's world, censorship is all the hype. And people tend to hide from serious topics instead of talking about them. Degrassi is a show that embraces the seriousness and wants to educate the viewer about the world around them, more or less. With the popularity of shows like Euphoria, a show like Degrassi I think would be more popular than ever in today's market. Degrassi is a show that was created to bring light to serious issues, and anyone who has gone through something can find themselves within Degrassi. Degrassi is a show that's not popular because it's so over the top, rather because... Thanks for watching.